Good morning, I'm Miguel Lopes, Head of Monitoring and Technology at WaveEc. We can start. Okay. This team is composed of six people who are working in this issue. And as I say in this slide, our goal is to make it happen in the sense that we need to develop the technology and monitor it so that this new industry becomes a reality. I put there six different activities which we have been doing lately. Some of them in which we are very experienced on, such as due diligences and strategic studies of technologies, many of these studies for utilities, and also performance monitoring, which we have been doing mostly at Pico. Other things that we have been doing are related to experience of our own team members, such as wave tank testing and resource evaluation. And the two other points that I put there are related to the things that we are now developing and we feel are important. So, okay. So about the work we have been doing in monitoring and technology, we had the luck to participate in a lot of prototype testing projects. And the most significant of them is the Pico plant. The Pico plant, we have been working on it since the beginning of WaveEc, so since 2003. And since 2005, we own and operate the plant. Slowly, we have the plant working. And since 2009, the plant is producing energy and delivering it to the grid. But more important than that, all the data generated at the plant is publicly available, and there are scientists from all over the world working on it, and we are able to do really interesting studies from the work being done there. We also have experience in some other prototype projects, like the AWS, right in the beginning of WaveEc in 2003-2004. We also had a small participation in the Pelemis project in Portugal in 2008. And lately, we have been doing work in two prototype tests, one in the wave roller in Peniche, which you already heard about, and the other one is an OPT deployment, which is being done in the north of Spain. In these projects, we have been doing performance and environmental monitoring. I saved my third slide to show you things that we are going to do in the future and which are different from the past. I would have to highlight the work we will do regarding the demonstration of the WindFloat technology. There's this European project called DemoFloat, which will now in practice start, and which shows how we are expanding our activities to offshore wind. So it was more, this change of name was more a consequence of our expansion of activities rather than the other way around. And the last point I would like to make is what are the types of tools that we are looking to develop. One of them is related to ROV tools. So WaveEc has acquired recently an ROV, which is an inspection ROV, but we find a lot of potential in it for developing tools, and we are already doing work on that, for example, in a tool to make underwater electrical connections of data cables or electrical cables. And other three issues that we will work on, okay, the other issues that we will work on in the future are these three that I pointed there. One of them is weather windows, which are very important in practice, because we are working in a rough environment when we are deploying this type of technologies. So the knowledge of weather windows, either for wave, wind, current, are all very important to being able to operate a single device, and even more when we are looking at a farm. And other issues that we are looking to in the next year, or let's say, are data transmission and underwater grid connection components. So this was what I had to say. And then I leave the floor to my colleague, Teresa Simas.